There is no other name that I know. I know the wonderful name. Jesus Christ, Jesus, the wonderful name. Jesus, there is no other name I know. Oh, yes, the wonderful name.
Lord, is his Lord,
is Lord. Oh, He is Lord. Amen. He has risen from the dead. He is Lord. Every knee shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. Amen. He has risen from the dead. He is Lord. Every knee shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Our Father in heaven, again, we magnify you tonight. Go ahead and just begin to exalt him tonight. Go ahead and just begin to give him praise tonight. He is Lord. He is the Lord of our lives. He is the Lord of over everything. Father, we give you praise tonight. Father, we give you honor tonight. Father, we worship and adore you. Father, we worship and exalt you tonight. Father, we worship and glorify you tonight. Father, we worship and lift you up. What a good God you are. What an awesome God you are. What a glorious God you are. We give you praise, our God. We give you honor, our God. We worship and adore you, our God. We worship and exalt you, our God. Tonight again, we declare you as our Lord. We acknowledge you as our Lord. We give you praise. We give you honor. We worship you. We exalt you. Accept our praises. Accept our worship. Accept our thanksgiving tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, again, we welcome you in our midst. Holy Spirit, we invite you. We welcome you. We acknowledge you as we pray to the Father tonight, as we praise tonight. Help us to praise in the Spirit. Help us to pray in the Spirit. Help us to give thanks in the Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Father, we appreciate you. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' precious name, we are praying. In Jesus' precious name, we are praying. Tonight, I want to welcome you to this first day of our 7 days of consecration prayer for the new year. Hallelujah. And by God's grace tonight, we're going to be focusing on Thanksgiving. We're going to be thanking the Lord. We're going to be appreciating him. We're going to be building it from today with Thanksgiving. So we're laying the foundation with Thanksgiving. By God's grace tonight, we're laying the foundation with Thanksgiving. And we pray that by the grace of the Almighty God, the God of heaven himself, is going to hear our Thanksgiving tonight. He's going to hear our praises tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. We bless you. In Jesus' name, look at my camera. It's off a little bit. Let me try to fix that. Hallelujah. Amen. I've not been looking at that. Okay, let's see. That will be better. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Again, as I said, I welcome you to this first day of our New Year fast and praying. And as always, we always dedicate the first day of our fast to Thanksgiving, to thank him and to appreciate him, to acknowledge him for all the things that he has done. Thanksgiving is very, very important to God. Thanksgiving is very, very crucial in our walk with God. God demands thanksgiving from us. So what is thanksgiving? What is thankfulness? Thanksgiving or thankfulness is a mental or verbal acknowledgement or appreciation of God's acts in our life. Thanksgiving is an acknowledgement of the deeds of God in our life, the hearts of God in our life, the hands of God in our life, is appreciation of God's acts in our life. Sometimes we have to think to see his acts in our lives But most time we don't have to, because it's just there. The hand of God is there. The heart of God is in our life. So sometimes we have to think and think before we can think of the heart of God. But most of the time, the heart of God is in our life. Why must I engage in Thanksgiving tonight? Just want to lay that foundation as we thank God tonight. We appreciate God tonight. Why must I thank God? Why is it that it's important that you and I must engage in Thanksgiving? The Bible made us to understand in Psalm 100 and verse 4, enter his gate with thanksgiving, his court with praise. Thanksgiving is very, very important. So why must I engage in thankfulness? Why must I engage in attitude of gratitude for the heart and the deeds of God in my life? Number one, thanksgiving acknowledge God in our life as the doer of the act, as the one that has done the things that we see, the things that we enjoy. So he acknowledged God as the doer of it. Yes, you are the one. Yes, eventually God has to help you to do it. You contribute part of it. God do his own. You do his own. But acknowledging the part of God, acknowledging the part of God is thanksgiving. That you are not full of yourself. That I'm not the one that brought myself here. I'm not the one that passed the exam myself. I'm not the one that find your husband myself. I'm not the one that made the baby myself. But God was the one that make it happen. Because the part of God is as important as anything. It's the most important part of it. So thanksgiving is acknowledging the act of God in our life. Acknowledging him as the actor. Acknowledging him as the one that make it happen. Number two, thanksgiving honors God. Thanksgiving bring honor to God. You know, when we thank God, we are bringing honor to him. We are bringing glory to him for the things that he have done. He brings glory to God. The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 15, this is what Apostle Paul said. He said, for all things are for your sake, that grace, having spread through the many, may cause thanksgiving to abound to the glory of God. Thanksgiving is to return the glory to God. In that story, I think it's Luke 19 now, about the 10 lepers that were cleansed. Jesus Christ said, where are they now? Is it only this foreigner, this Samaritan that came back to return the glory to God? Thanksgiving is bring glory. He returns glory. He returns honor to our God. Why must I engage in thanksgiving? Because he honors God. Why must I engage in thanksgiving? Because thanksgiving is a command of the scripture. The scripture commands us to engage in thanksgiving. The scripture that I quoted before, Psalm 100 verse 4, enter his gate with thanksgiving and his court with praise, is a give thanks to him, because God deserves our thanks. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 18, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 18, he says, in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God concerning you. So the scripture commands us to give thanksgiving, to thank God, to be thankful. The other side, or the opponent, or the opposite of thanksgiving is to be full of complaint or to be grumbling. And we, you and I know that God can't stand complainers. God can't stand murmurers. God can't stand complainers. We saw that in the journey of the children of Israel. One of the major reasons why their 11 days journey had to turn to 40 years was because they lack gratitude in their heart. They lack gratitude in their heart. So tonight, I know that there's gratitude in your heart, but we must verbalize that gratitude. We must thank God, because that's the will of God concerning us. Colossians chapter 15, or 3 chapter 15, Colossians 3, 15 also said, we must give thanks. We must give thanks. Why must I give thanks? Why must I engage in thanksgiving? Because thanksgiving make me to focus on the goodness of the Lord. Thanksgiving make me to focus on the goodness of God. Thanksgiving make me to focus on what the Lord has done or what the Lord is doing in my life. So one way or the other, when you are engaging in thanksgiving, it takes your attention away from your problem. It takes your attentions away from the things that does not work and help you to focus on the things that are work. Because really thanksgiving is for the things that we enjoy, the benefit that we enjoy, the goodness that God has done, the miracle that God has done, the breakthrough that God has done. And the more you focus on that, the bigger God become in your life. The bigger God, your perspective about God continue to change and become bigger and bigger and bigger than your problem. Thanksgiving is very, very important. You and I must engage in thanksgiving. And finally, why must I engage in thanksgiving? Because to be unthankful is thrown out by God. To be unthankful is thrown out by God. God does not like us not to be full of thanksgiving, not to acknowledge Him. The book of Romans chapter 1, verse 21, I'm going to read to us. Romans chapter 1, verse 21, it says, hallelujah. Romans 1:21, I want to read it. It says, because although they knew God, they did not glorify Him as God, nor were thankful. Because of that, they become futile in their imaginations, their thought, and their foolish heart were darkened. God frowned at unthankfulness, not being thankful for His goodness and for His kindness. And when you read it further in that Romans chapter 1, we see everything that started with that not acknowledging God in our lives. You know, it's a dark road, it's a slippery road downhill when we refuse to acknowledge God. And thanksgiving helps us to acknowledge God in our life. The book of 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 2 talk about that unthankfulness or not being thankful is one of the signs of the end time. It's one of apostasy, the things that will happen in the end time when people will be full of themselves and refuse to acknowledge God in their life. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 2, it says, for men will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boasters, proud, blasphemer, disobedient to parents, and unthankful, unholy. See, unthankful is in the category of unholy. It's in the category of unloving, unforgiving, slanderous. So God frowned at not being thankful. So tonight, I want us to come before the Lord on this first night of this 7 days of fast with a heart of gratitude. Tonight, we're going to be thanking God in three categories. And I'm going to be leading us. You know, we take some time to thank God. The first category of thanksgiving we're going to be thanking God tonight is we're going to thank God for the things that He has done in our lives. Some of the things that you and I know that God has done, maybe it happened for you some 20 years ago, maybe it happened for you 3 months ago. We're going to thank God according to Colossians 1:12. We're going to be thanking the Lord. Let me read that Colossians 1:12 to us. This is what Apostle Paul wrote to the Colossians. He says, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. Verse 13, he said, He has delivered us from the power of darkness and conveyed unto us into the kingdom of His love, in whom we have redemption through His blood and the forgiveness of our sin. Tonight, we're going to go before the Lord. We're going to begin to thank God for redemption, for the forgiveness of our sin. I want you to begin to thank Him Because the Bible says, if the Lord imputed iniquity, who is going to stand? Nobody will be able to stand before him. The reason why we are able to stand before him today is because he has forgiven us. He has redeemed us by the blood of his son, Jesus. So I want you to begin to thank him tonight and just begin to appreciate him. Father, tonight again, we come before you with a heart of thanksgiving to thank you for the redemption of our life. Father, I want to thank you for the salvation of my soul. Father, I want to thank you for forgiveness of my sin. Thank you for redemption in the blood of Jesus. Thank you for the cleansing that I received by the blood of Jesus. Thank you because my sins are not against me anymore. Thank you because I have been justified by the blood of Jesus. Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you tonight for the salvation of my soul. I thank you tonight for eternal life. I thank you for the Zoe life of God that is living inside of me. I thank you for eternity. I thank you, Jesus, for abundance life. I thank you, Jesus. I appreciate you for forgiveness of my sin. Tonight, I want to say thank you. I want to say thank you. Oh, Daddy, I want to thank you for the salvation of my soul. I give you all the praise. I give you all the honor. I worship and adore you. Thank you for redemption tonight. Thank you for forgiveness of sin tonight. I give you praise. I give you honor. I want you to lift up your voice and thank him tonight for deliverance from the power of darkness. Listen to me, people of God. He said he has delivered us. Not that he's going to deliver us. You and I have been delivered from the power of darkness. We are no longer anchorships in the hand of Satan. Satan can't do anything with us. He can't do anything with our life because we are no longer in his kingdom. We have been delivered from the power of darkness. Hallelujah. So I want you to lift up your voice tonight and begin to thank God for deliverance from the power of darkness. Power of darkness has no authority over you again because you have been delivered. You have been set free from the power of darkness. The Bible says, he that the Son has set free is free indeed. We have been delivered from the power of darkness. So I want you to lift up your voice and say, Father, thank you for delivering me from the power of darkness. Thank you for delivering me from the power of darkness. Thank you. I thank you today. I appreciate you today. I give you praise today. I give you honor tonight. Thank you for deliverance from the power of darkness. Thank you for deliverance from the power of darkness. Thank you for deliverance from power of wickedness. Thank you for deliverance from power of evil, the power of witchcraft, the power of wizard. Thank you for deliverance from every curse of the law. Thank you for deliverance for everything that has to do with darkness. I give you praise tonight. I give you all the honor tonight. I acknowledge you today as my deliverer. I acknowledge you today as my redeemer. I acknowledge you tonight again as the one that has delivered my soul. My soul is free. Father, I thank you. Father, I give you praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' precious name, we are praying. Not only that you have been delivered from the power of darkness, you have been translated. He says, and convict us. We are thanking God tonight. We are thanking God for what the Lord has done. We are thanking God for what the Lord has done. The Lord has saved you. The Lord has redeemed you. The Lord has justified you. The Lord has delivered you from the power of darkness. Not only delivered you and left you stranded. No, he has conveyed you. He has moved you into where? The kingdom of the Son of his love. Hallelujah. That Sunday we are talking about the love of God. So tonight again, we're going to lift up our voice. I'm going to say, Father, thank you for translating me, for conveying me into the kingdom of your Son, the kingdom of love. Father, thank you that I am now in the kingdom of God. I am now in the kingdom of heaven. I am now in the kingdom of love, kingdom of peace, kingdom of
of joy. Father, I am now in the kingdom where Jesus reigns supremely. I am now in the kingdom where God of peace reigns supremely. I am now in the kingdom of God. I am no longer in the kingdom of darkness. I am no longer in the kingdom of the world, but I'm in the kingdom of God. My principles and the laws of my kingdom are supreme to the law of this world. Father, I thank you tonight. Lift up your voice and thank him. Lift up your voice and just magnify him tonight. Jehovah, we give you praise. Jehovah, we give you honor. Jehovah, we worship and adore you. Thank you for deliverance from the kingdom of darkness and translating us into the kingdom of your love. Of your son Jesus, we give you praise. Daddy, I thank you for this that you have done. I give you all the honor. I worship and adore you. I worship and exalt you. Oh, thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' precious name, we are praying. Colossians chapter 1, verse 12 says, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us. It didn't say who is going to qualify us. You are qualified to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. So I wanted to thank God that you are qualified. Everything that heaven has in store for saints, for the people that have been redeemed, you are qualified to be partaker of it. You are qualified to be partaker of the kingdom and power. You are qualified to be partaker of kingdom glory. You are qualified to partake in kingdom provision. You are qualified to partake in kingdom life. Tonight, I want you to lift up your voice and say, Father, thank you for qualifying me to be partakers of the inheritance of the saint in the light. The inheritance of the saint in the light. Oh, Father, thank you for qualifying me. Thank you because I am not disqualified. I am qualified. By you, I am qualified to receive eternal life. I am qualified to enjoy victory. I am qualified to enjoy victory of Jesus. I am qualified to enjoy divine help. I am qualified to enjoy divine health. I am qualified to walk in power. I am qualified to enjoy ministry of the Holy Spirit. I am qualified to enjoy the ministry of angels. I am qualified to enjoy the power of God. So lift up your voice tonight and just begin to thank God that you are qualified to, you are qualified. Every inheritance that God has for his saints, you are qualified for it. You are qualified for it. So thank God tonight. It's not that you are going to be qualified. You are already qualified. And that's why we are thanking God tonight for the things that he has done. He's the one that has qualified us. Father, we thank you. Father, we give you all the praise. Father, we give you all the honor. Jehovah, we bless you. Jehovah, we exalt you tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we thank you, Jesus. Oh, we bless your name, Jesus. Thank you for qualifying me to be partaker, to be partaker, to be part of those that enjoy every inheritance that you have for us as your saints in the light. Thank you, Father. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we give you honor. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you, Jesus, for all that you have done. Thank you, Jesus, for all that you have done. Thank you, Jesus, for all that you have done. Thank you, Jesus, for all that you have done. The book of Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3, it says, blessed be our God who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. Tonight, we're going to lift up our voice. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3. God has blessed you and I with every spiritual blessing. It says, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who have blessed us. God has endowed you blessed. God has endowed me blessed. So I wanted to thank God tonight and appreciate God. He says, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessings in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. I'm going to say, Father, thank you for blessing me already. I am blessed. I am blessed. Thank you because you have blessed me with every spiritual blessing that can be mentioned in the heavenly places. Thank you for blessing me with every spiritual blessing. Thank you for blessing me. Thank you for blessing me. Thank you for blessing me. Lord, I thank you tonight. Lord, I appreciate you tonight for blessing me with every spiritual blessings in the heavenly places. Father, thank you for blessing me with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for blessing me. Thank you for blessing me. Thank you for blessing me. Thank you for blessing me with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. Tonight I am grateful for all your blessings in my life, spiritual blessings, physical blessings, material blessings, emotional blessings. I give you praise. I give you honor. I worship you tonight. I exalt you tonight. We give you all the praise. In Jesus' precious name, amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14 says, now thanks be to God who always lead us in triumph. Thanks be to God who always lead us in triumph in Christ Jesus, and through us diffuses the fragrance of his knowledge in every place. We're going to thank God for leading you in triumph, leading you in victory. We are a part of his victory parade. The God of heaven has fought Jesus has fought the battle for us. And we are part of his victory parade. Oh, we are part of his victory parade. We are part of his victory parade. So we're going to lift up our voice tonight and say, Father, thank you for you always lead me in triumph. You always lead me in victory. You always lead me in triumph. You always lead me in victory. I give you praise tonight. I give you honor tonight. I worship and adore you tonight. I worship and exalt you tonight. I give you praise, Jehovah. I give you honor tonight. Lord, I worship you. Lord, I exalt you. Lord, I glorify you. Thank you for always, not sometimes. Sometimes lead us. No. Always. That means every time we are in victorious procession. Every time you are in victorious procession, even though life might be look as if it's down, but the Bible says that you are in a victory parade. You are winning in the name of Jesus. Ultimately, you are winning in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you because you are leading me always into triumph. Thank you for triumph in Christ Jesus. Thank you for victory in Christ Jesus. I give you all the praise. I give you all the honor. Jehovah will bless you. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you for always leading us in triumph. Thank you for always leading us in victory. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' precious name we are praying. The second category of prayer is that we are going to thank God again for the things that he is doing currently in our life. He is doing currently in our life. He has sustained our life. He has by his mercy and his grace. The psalmist said in Psalm 3, verse 5, he says, I lay down and slept. I awoke, for the Lord sustained me. The reason why you and I were here is because the Lord sustain us. The Lord sustain us. The Lord sustain us. The Lord has sustained you by his grace, by his mercy. So tonight I want you to acknowledge the sustainer of life. I want you to acknowledge the one that sustained your life. It's not your physical exercise that sustains your life. It's not the medicine that you take that sustain your life. Is God that has sustained you. So I want you to acknowledge him, because really, if God stops sustaining us, we're done. Kaput, that's it. We're finished. But God, David said, I lay down, I slept, I awoke, for the Lord sustained me. For the Lord sustained me. The Lord sustained me. Every day you sleep, you wake up. Every day we sleep, we wake up. Every day we sleep, we wake up. God sustain us. God is doing that in our life. Every day is doing that. He said his mercy is new every day. Every day, every day. So tonight I want to lift up our voice. Father, we thank you today. Father, we appreciate you today for this that you are doing in our life. Thank you for sustaining my life. Daddy, I thank you for sustaining my life. I thank you for sustaining me physically. I thank you that I'm alive today. I thank you that I'm alive right now. I thank you that I'm alive right now. I give you all the praise. I give you all the honor. I worship and adore you. I worship and exalt you. I worship and glorify you. I worship and lift you up. What a good God you are. Thank you that I'm alive right now. Mighty Father, thank you. Ancient of this, thank you. Everlasting Father, thank you that I'm alive today. I give you praise. I give you praise. I give you honor. I worship you, Jesus. I exalt you, Jesus. I give you glory, Jesus. Oh, makande boroko sheketelia. Yeklo prakaza toliko prokozi preketelia. Yeplande soko prekozi prokozi gadabosta. Rinda gabarande gedeborosa. Yeklo prede gedesia. Yikla braduske tende kolonda kaprakotosta. Yika paradia kosokotolia. Yeklo briando kosianda labrosa. Father, thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for the Zoe life of God that is flowing through me. Father, I give you praise. Thank you for sustaining me from 2020 to 2021, from yesterday to today. Father, I thank you. Daddy, I appreciate you. Daddy, I give you praise. Daddy, I give you honor. Daddy, I worship and adore you. Thank you for sustaining my life. I give you praise. I give you honor. I worship and adore you. I worship and exalt you. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be your holy name. Again, tonight we're going to lift up our voice. The book of Psalm 68, verse 19. It says, blessed be the God. Blessed be the God who daily, daily load us with benefit. He said, who daily load us with benefit. Who daily what? Load us. God is doing that in our life. Loading you and I with benefit every day. A benefit every day. We cannot count those benefits. But I want us to acknowledge him again tonight and thank him for his daily benefit. Father, thank you for your daily benefit in my life, in my family, in my home, in my ministry. Thank you for the daily benefit. Thank you for the daily blessing. Thank you for the daily benefit. Thank you for the daily blessing. Thank you, Jehovah, for the daily blessing. Daily blessing of provision, of protection. Daily blessing of guidance. Daily blessing of leading. Thank you, Jesus, for this that you are doing consistently. You are doing it even right now. Lord, I give you all the praise. Lord, I give you all the honor. Father, what shall I render to the Lord for all his benefit towards me? Father, I thank you. Father, I praise you. Oh, what I give you praise. Hey, what shall I render? Oh, what shall I render? What shall I render to you, oh Lord? I will praise your name. I shout hallelujah. What shall I render to you, oh Lord? Hey, what shall I render? What shall I render for all your benefit? What shall I render? Psalm 116, verse 12. He says, what shall I render to the Lord for all his benefit towards me? For all his benefit towards me. For all his benefit towards me. Hey, what shall I render? What shall I render? What shall I render to you, oh Lord? I will praise your name and shout hallelujah. What shall I render to you, oh Lord? I render praises. I render praises. I render praises to you, oh Lord. I will praise your name. I shout hallelujah.
I render praises to you, O Lord. Oh, I render dancing. I render dancing. I render dancing to you, O Lord. I will praise your name. I shout hallelujah. I render praises to you, oh Lord. Father, I render praises to you tonight. I render praises to you for your daily benefit in my life, the benefit that I'm enjoying even right now. I give you all the praise, the benefit of being alive, the benefit of divine protection, the benefit of mercy, the benefit of your grace. I give you all the praise. I give you all the honor. Jehovah, I bless you. Jehovah, I exalt you. Jehovah, I give you praise. Oh, what the wondrous Son God you are. Daddy, what a glorious God you are. I give you glory. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' precious name, we are praying. Hallelujah. And the third category of our thanksgiving tonight is we're going to thank God for the thing that he's about to do for you and I. Oh, God has planned for you. God has purpose for you. God has planned for you. God has purpose for you. The book of Jeremiah 29 verse 11, talk about the plan that God has for you and I. He says, it's a good plan. He says, for I know the thought that I think towards you, says the Lord, thought of peace, not of evil, to give you a future, to give you a hope. That's the plan of God. That's the plan of God. That's the plan of God. What is the plan of God for us as a church, as God's people this year, is to blossom, to flourish, to increase, to be fruitful, to grow up in the name of Jesus. So we're going to thank God tonight for what he's about to do, for bringing you and I into this new year. It's because God still has plan for your life. God still has plan for you. You're going to be married. You're going to have your children. You are going to have your job. You are going to have your business in the mighty name of Jesus. So I want you to lift up your voice to heaven again tonight and say, Father, thank you for your good plan for me, your good plan for my family, your good plan and your purpose for me. Daddy, I give you all the praise. Daddy, I give you all the honor. Tonight, I'm thanking you for your good plan, a glorious future, a glorious destiny that you have for me. Thank you for a glorious plan, a glorious destiny. The Bible says, he said, man, the righteous man, he said, the head of that man, he said, is glorious. The hand of that man is glorious. The hand of that man is glorious. The future of that man is glorious. Father, thank you for a glorious future. Thank you for a glorious tomorrow. Thank you for a tomorrow that is secure in you. Thank you for a future that is secure in you. Thank you for a glorious future. Thank you, Father, for a secure future. Thank you for a glorious future. Thank you for a secure future. Thank you. I give you praise tonight. I give you honor tonight. Thank you, Lord Jehovah. I thank you. Oh, Lord Jehovah, I give you praise. Lord Jehovah, I give you honor. Blessed be your holy name. In the book of Matthew, when Jesus Christ was teaching us how the disciple to pray, Matthew chapter 6, verse 9, he said, when you are praying, Matthew 6, verse 9, he says, when you pray, go into your room, shut the door. He says, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on this heart. Your will be done on this heart. Believer, saint, dearly beloved, the will of the Lord for you this year, the will of the Lord for your family this year is that you will grow up and you will flourish, which summarily means you will blossom. You will blossom this year. That's the will of the Lord. So we're going to thank God that the will of the Lord, oh, is going to come to pass concerning you in this year 2021 in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for your will for me in 2021. Thank you, Father, for your will to blossom, your will for me to blossom in the year 2021. Thank you, Father, for your purpose for me to prosper in the year 2021. Thank you for your will to
survive and escape in this year 2021, the plague that is in the land. Father, I give you all the praise. Father, I give you all the honor. Thank you for your plan of escape. Thank you for your plan of exemption. Thank you for the plan of escape. Thank you for the plan of exemption. Thank you, Father, for your good and perfect plan concerning my life. I give you all the praise. That I give you all the honor. Jehovah, I worship and adore you. Jehovah, I worship and exalt you, Lord. Jehovah, I worship and glorify you, Lord. Jehovah, I worship and lift your name on high. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be exalted. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy to be magnified. Everlasting Father, I thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Lord, I thank you. Oh, Lord, I praise you. Oh, Lord, I exalt you, Lord. Oh, Lord, I give you praise. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I give you praise. Lord, I give you honor. Jehovah, I worship you. Jehovah, I magnify you. What a good God you are. What an awesome God you are. What a glorious God you are. I give you praise, Jehovah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your plan to me. Thank you, Father. I give you all the glory. I worship you, O God. I magnify you. Thank you, Lord Jehovah. Lord, I bless your name. Lord, I exalt your name. Lord, I give you all the glory. Thank you for every victory in my future. Thank you for every triumph in my future. Thank you for every breakthrough in my future. Thank you for every miracle in my future. Thank you for every blessing in my future. Thank you for the progress in my future. I give you all the praise. I give you all the honor. Jehovah, I bless you. Thank you for the plan to blossom me physically, to blossom my life physically. In the mighty name of Jesus, to flourish in my health. Thank you for your plan to flourish in ministry, to flourish in my finances. I give you all the praise. I give you all the honor. Tonight, again, I'm just acknowledging you. Thank you for the things that you have done in the past. Thank you for the things that you are doing right now. And thank you for the things that you are about to do, the thing that you're going to do in this year. Father, thank you for every one of your plans. Your good plan for me. I give you praise. I give you honor. I'm just acknowledging you again tonight as my good God, as my good Father. I give you praise. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' precious name we are praying. I want us to lift up our voice again tonight before we go. I want us to thank God for this nation. I want us to appreciate God and thank God for this nation. The things that God has helped this nation to escape for this election, and that there's still peace today. I want us to thank God and just appreciate God and just say, Father, we thank you again for what you did for the election, peaceful election. We thank you for the things that have been coming up and the way the things have been handled. Father, we thank you that today we are still at peace. Yes, even though there is still that political uncertainty, but we thank you because of the things that you have done already. We thank you for the peaceful election. We thank you for a very clear-cut winner. We thank you for your plan and your purpose that you have for this nation. Again, we thank you because there's going to be a peaceful transition and there's going to be a restoration for this nation, restoration of healing, a physical restoration of healing, of health. There's going to be social restoration in this nation. There's going to be financial restoration. There's going to be also religious and moral restoration in this nation in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you tonight. Father, we appreciate you. Oh, Daddy, we give you all the praise. Daddy, we give you all the honor. We thank you for America. We thank you for the way that you have helped this nation. Oh, even with the virus, we thank you for the way you helped this nation. Yes, we thank you. We appreciate you. We give you all the praise. We give you all the honor. We acknowledge you again tonight. We say thank you. We bless you. We exalt you. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be exalted. You are worthy to be glorified. What a good God you are. What an awesome God you are. We give you praise. We give you honor. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' precious name, we are praying. Again, tonight, we lift up our hands unto you to say thank you. Today, we are dedicating it to Thanksgiving. We are dedicating it to acknowledging you for all that you have done for us. Oh, Father, we thank you for the past. We thank you for the past.
We thank you for redemption. We thank you for salvation. We thank you, Father, for the present. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for where we are today. We thank you, Father, for tomorrow. We thank you because you are taking us to a better place. We thank you because we have a glorious future. We have a secure future in you. We thank you for your hand that is upon our life. We thank you for your plan of to blossom us, to cause us to flourish, to cause us to prosper in this new year 2021. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we give you all the honor. Jehovah, we bless you. Jehovah, we exalt you. Again tonight, for every one of your children that have joined tonight, to return the glory to you, to thank you. Just like you make all that one foreigner, the leper that returned, and you said, yes, your faith has made you whole. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, everything that needs wholeness in the life of these, your children, under my voice tonight, my Father, my God, I pray that everything and anything that needs wholeness, that need to be made whole in their life, Father, I pray that tonight you will make it whole. In the mighty name of Jesus, that their miracle will be completed. Their super, that turnaround shall be completed. In the mighty name of Jesus, that every miracle that is still half measure, my Father, my God, by the virtue of the thanksgiving tonight, by the virtue of praise tonight, Lord, I pray that you will complete it for them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Father, we appreciate you. Father, we give you praise. I pray for you again tonight that this year, 2021, every plan of God to cause you to blossom will come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus, that you will experience flourishing in every area of your life, spiritually, physically, financially, emotionally, in the mighty name of Jesus. And as the Lord has declared to us, you have escaped. In the mighty name of Jesus, you have escaped this pandemic. And the end of this pandemic, you will still be standing. Your family will still be standing. Your career will still be standing. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be your holy name. We give you praise. We give you honor. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen. Who did it? Jesus did it. Hallelujah. I'm just returning the glory to God. Jesus did it, and I'm acknowledging him in my life. Hallelujah. Please continue to acknowledge him in your life for the little things, for the small things, for the big things, for the minor things. Continue to acknowledge God. When you wake up, acknowledge him. That is the one that caused you to sleep. There are people that have water bed and could not sleep.
Lord.
There are people that work and have all the best things of this world. But they can't.
Amen.
You have to acknowledge every heart of God in your life. And that you see God in Jesus' name. Tomorrow,
amen.
Continue the fast. The time is 7:30. Let's come together to pray. As we I don't want you to miss any of this fast. As we begin to lay the foundation. You know, this is the beginning. And beginning is very, very important. Very, very important. The Bible says, in the beginning was the word. You need the voice of God at the beginning of the year. You need the voice of God. It's the voice of God that frame. You know, when you frame, you put something in picture. And what we're going to be doing in these 7 days is to be framing our world, be framing this 2021, so that this is what we want there. You know, you frame a picture, you put the picture that you want there. And by God's grace,
hello.
As we frame, who's here? Who shall it be? Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful night. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you.
God bless you. In the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God.
Jesus Christ, the love of God.
And the
fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
Be with us now and forevermore.